Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Welcome to another video on Room. In this video, we will move on beyond the introduction to Room and we will concentrate on demystifying the entity. That is the very basic class that you have to create to get started with Room setup. Even before you write a single line about entity, data access object or converters, the first thing that you have to do is add the Room dependencies. What are the Room dependencies? These are the three things. That is Room Common, Room Compiler, and Room KTX. You need to add these dependencies because the way Room works is it is a kind of a annotation that you use with the classes, and you need an annotation processor which converts these annotations into an intermediate class. We will see what are those intermediate classes and what they look like much later during the demo phase later. But these are the three dependencies that you will have to add to your application. Now, one thing we should be aware is that even though we are using this Room persistence library, at the end of the day, it is still a database, a relational database with rows and columns. You have a table name and then you have columns in that particular table. What entity allows you to do is convert a class with a table name and various attributes into columns. That is what entity allows you to do. For example, in this code, you might see the annotation entity being used. So when you use this particular entity annotation, you basically tell that I want to create a table with the name of the class. So in this case, you have a class called as country. So the table name in the database will be country. And then you have primary key declaration. So once again, what you are telling is I want a column called ID with integer data type, and that is the primary key and it should be auto-generated. And then you can have any number of attributes in the class, the entity class, and for each of those attributes of the class, you will have a column in the database. And sometimes if you don't want certain attributes to be created in the database because maybe you don't need them in the offline approach that you want to take, you don't need that particular data to be persisted for the offline access. In that case, you can use another annotation called as ignore. So these columns would not get created in the database. So this is the very bare minimum thing you have to do to get started with the entity. So let's get into a demo and see how it works. Let me open the build.gradle file. And if you come down here, I don't have the room. These are the three room dependencies. And I will also have to apply the capped plugin, that is Kotlin annotation processor. So let me add that as well. And now sync it. And if you are wondering what is this particular application, it is the same application that we have worked with before as well. These information about the cards of the countries is getting loaded into the application from a raw XML file. If you go to resource raw, there is this countries JSON file. I am basically reading this particular countries JSON file and then rendering that particular screen. Instead of that, I want to read this and put it in a SQLite database using the Room library. Now here under the data, you have country. As of now, it is just a serializable. So first thing that you will have to do is add the annotation processor entity, and then you will have to create a primary key. That is primary key auto generated true, and you want to have a variable argument int. Please ensure that this is a nullable type. Because it was earlier a serializable class, all these attributes would have been a val type. But while working with the entity, it is better to create this as var type, because when you create a val and when this gets compiled into a Java class, because of the annotation processor, it creates a final odd spellings or final area or final capital. And when you have a final, you cannot have a setter. But entity annotation processor tries to add a setter to this particular attribute. And with a val, you can't do that. And that creates once again a compilation process. So once again, convert all these val into vars. Everything is a variable instead of a value. And I may choose to decide ignore certain things. For example, this quota of ohms, I don't need it. So I will add a ignore. And I can do pretty much same with, say, denominations. I don't need that. And maybe this multiple translation, I don't need that. More or less other things, I need it. Next comes, how do I deal with complicated data types? For example, integer is by default supported by entity, that is room, that is SQLite database. Double, string, all those things by default is supported by SQLite. But if you have list of strings, maps, and information like car, which is once again another class, this is a little bit more complicated. We need to basically convert this into something that can be stored in the SQLite database. So if you are receiving a JSON data type for this particular car, then it is better to convert into a string representation of this particular car class and then store it and then read it as a JSON string, convert it into an object and then use it. To do that, we use something called as converter. Let me show you how it is done. I will create another package. Let me call it as database. Anything related to database, I will create here. And under this, I will create a class called as converters. Let me split the screen. I will create an instance of JSON format. I would be using these to convert it into a JSON string and JSON string into an object. For example, let's consider this. This is a list of strings. So what I will do is, as you can see here, now I have updated my Android Studio and it is working with Jellyfish, and you can enable the AI code completion. I can write type converter. Type converter is another annotation which is part of the room. And here you can write function from string list to JSON and value string list string. And what you have to return is value let JSON format encode to string IT. It's giving a compilation error. Add the extension. That should take care of it. So basically what this does is, if you encounter a list of string, it converts it into a JSON list string equivalent. In the same way, I need to write another type converter, that is function, that is from JSON string list to JSON string to list. And what it receives a string and converts that into list of strings. How? Value let JSON format decode from string it. This is a lambda function and this should work fine. If you are wondering how this works fine, what I can do is, I can quickly show you by writing a unit test. Let me create a converter here and then write a unit test function test from JSON to string list. So it basically creates a JSON string, India, USA, UK, expected list. This is what I should get. Actual list, I am using converters from JSON string to list, JSON string, and I am doing assert equals. So let me just run this. Yeah, the test case passed. And in the same way, I can write another test, test function test from string to JSON. So this is the list of strings. This is what I should get back. And here I am actually using that particular method and I am asserting it. And let me run this test. So yeah, it is working fine. So I hope you now get the idea of why we are writing these converters. To save the time, I have already written a lot of converters here. For example, how to convert a capital info. Capital info is a separate data class itself. And in the same way, you have list of double, car, flags, maps, languages. So there are a lot of different data types that are there in the JSON. And I need to understand how to convert these things into an equivalent string or an appropriate data while storing them into the SQLite database. That is exactly the reason why I have written this particular class, that is converters. if you don't write this, then it will create a problem later, because when you create the database, you need to tell what converter class it needs to use while storing and retrieving the data from the SQLite database. At that time, you will have to pass this particular class, which is a converter class. And that is the reason why we have created this particular class. So we have just gotten started with creation of the entity, added a primary key annotation, added the ignore, where we want to ignore certain things, and then we have added the converters as well. It is about to get more interesting in the next video, when we will start consuming these things with data access class and database. So stay tuned for the next
video. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.